brown-eyed girl. Morning, Flyers. Welcome back to the Early Bird. Happy Friday. I'm your host, Griffin Yarmaloff, and alongside me, as always, is the man, Mr. Shea Curry.
What's up, Flyers?
Oh, happy Friday, Flyers. We have a great show for you today. It's going to be heading in your direction right now, so let's roll the intro. So, Shea and I saw the Batman last week, and it was great. But during my review, Shea got a little confused upstairs when I had a couple of film words to say while reviewing it. So today,
the score.
Yeah, the score, the music of the film. So today we'll be going over some film terms. There's going to be a total of five film terms, Shea. You need to get all five right. Do you know why?
Because there's a prize.
Yes. I haven't told Shea what the prize is. Unknown to Shea, if he gets all five questions right, he wins munchkins for the entire crew. So, yeah, the pressure's on. Are you ready?
Oh my lord, yeah.
Okay, five film terms, five questions. Let's go five for five. God. Let's see the first one. Continuity.
Continuity. It's the flow of the movie.
Okay. Can I get us more in depth?
Continuity. Like, oh, you have to keep the I know what it means.
Okay.
You have to keep, like, the pace and, like, if a coffee's, like, on the table in this scene, it's got to be there the next
scene. That's perfect. That's one question. That was close. I didn't know if you're going to get that one.
Oh, my God.
All right. One for one. Let's see if you get the next one. Cross-cutting.
I'm sorry, guys.
If you want, I can kind of guide you in the right direction here.
Can I, like, phone a friend?
No phoning a friend, but I can kind of talk to this. Right, so yeah. Think about cross-cutting. So if you're cross-cutting, that means you must have
two separate clips.
And you
mesh them together by cross-cutting.
That's two for two, people.
That counts.
He's getting it. He's getting there. I'm not doing all the work. All right, let's see the next one.
Cinematography. That's the different angles of the shots, how good the shots
are. Yeah,
yeah. All you talk
it's
about
the shot.
Oh my God.
He's three for three, folks. All right. He's three for three. We have two more, Shea. This is going to be a tough one. What's a mise en scène?
The middle of a scene.
Not.
But not exactly. That wasn't my answer.
Not quite. I can actually help you with this. Yeah. You actually were an actor in one of my mise en scènes. 2 years ago, during the first COVID summer, I was taking this film class, and I had you and Mr. G actors in this film. We filmed it at Farm Pond. He was a returning Army veteran. So knowing that is a mise-en-scene, what do you think that motion, what do you think it does?
Short film?
Yeah, it's kind of.
Short film that...
What does the no talking and the action of the camera do?
It creates emotion creates a story without having words.
Yes, he got it, folks. He got it.
A story without words.
He got it. He's getting there. All right. This is the last question. If you get this last question right, munchkins for the entire crew. Are you ready?
Yeah.
Okay. Name three Spielberg movies.
Steven Spielberg?
Steven Spielberg, yep. Not the other one.
Oh, man.
He has made several hits.
E.T.
E.T., that's one. That's
okay,
one.
Okay.
Hey!
E.T., Spielberg.
One came out fairly recently.
No Disney movies?
no Disney movies.
Oh man! Can you give me Jurassic Park?
Yeah, that's one. He did do all the Jurassic Park movies. You're right.
Okay. One more.
All right, I want you to get this one.
Jaws.
Yeah, she did do Jaws. Shea did it. Shea wins munchkins for the entire crew. Congratulations. He can name all the film terms. You can go to film school for that, Shea. How do you feel?
Oh man, I feel great. What flavors are in here?
Oh, man. It's only pumpkin. Oh, nah, I'm just kidding. I'm just kidding. Congratulations, Shea. Now live in the studio with the pledge is the man himself, Shea Carey.
This land is your land. This land is my land. From California to the New York Island. From the Redwood Forest to the Gulf Stream waters. This land was made for you and me.
Please stand for the pledge.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible with liberty and justice for all.
Episode, so let's kick it over to the podium for announcements.
Good morning, Flyers. So the dance team is going to New England this Saturday, March 12th. It's at Brookfield High School in Brookfield, Connecticut. And doors open at 11:30, so if you can, come out and support.
Good morning, Flyers. Hey, happy Friday. I just wanted to say happy Friday. And there's a secret that I want to tell you. Don't tell anybody, but Junior Cattell is happening on May 6th from 5 to 9 in Ashland at the Warren Conference Center in Ashland on May 6th from 5 to 9. It's going to be so epic. There's going to be dancing, food, fun, and games. It's going to be indoor and outdoor. It's going to be so much fun. And we are selling tickets in E206, only after school, only in E206. Today, and actually every day in March, but today and all of next week, ticket prices are going to be $80. That's right. They used to be $85. Now they're $80. Hey, you might be thinking, Joaquin, I already got a ticket because I listened to what you said last week and the past few days, and I bought a ticket, and it was $85. Well, guess what? Since they're $80 now, all you have to do is swing by E206 after school, and we'll give you a $5 refund if you already bought a ticket. If you haven't, you can get them for $80 today, and you can get them for $80 all the way up until the 18th. So I can't wait to see you. You can pay with cash or check, made out to the city of Framingham. I can't wait to see you.
Good morning, everyone. Happy Friday. I hope you had a great day yesterday. Just want to remind everyone about the MCAS that's coming up on March 22nd and 23rd. Please take a look at the s'more that I sent out, because if you take a bus, there's a special bus schedule running for our students in grades 9, 11, and 12. All 10th grade students need to be in on their regular time. The buses are going to do two runs that morning, but just take a look at the s'more that I sent out. I also want to tell the seniors that you received a s'more email from Ms. Jones, who's our World Language Department head. Please take a look at that because you may be eligible for the Seal of Biliteracy. This is a nationally recognized seal that students can earn as a result of being in the World Language Program. The seal is actually put on the diploma. So please take a look at that. There's certain criteria. You must come in on the 22nd, the same day as the MCAS, to take the exam that's aligned to earning that Seal of Biliteracy. So please look at that. There's also another criteria if you earned a 4 or 5 in a World Language AP exam. So it's a great opportunity. As I said, it's nationally recognized by colleges and universities. So that would be, if you're eligible, I strongly encourage you to come in on the 22nd and take the exam that's associated with the Seal of Biliteracy. And so that is everything for today, and good luck to the dance team and the cheer team. Cheer team's at Worcester State this weekend as well, participating, competing in states. So, all right, everyone, happy Friday. Have a great weekend. Back to Griffin and Shea.
That's all for today's episode of The Early Bird. If you enjoyed this episode and you want to watch it again, you can find it on our YouTube or on our Instagram bio at Framingham High Studios. Shea, congratulations. You have won Munchkins for the entire crew. How do you feel?
Oh, man, I feel great. Yeah. Oh, I feel so good.
You want a Disney World? Is that a Disney World?
Disney World. I've never been, but, hey, you know,
we'll get there. Well, shout out our track team down in New York competing at Nationals right now. Shout out Sam Burgess. Is it Sam Burgess? He's the younger one. Yeah, Sam Burgess. I was thinking it was Ben. Sam Burgess running an 8:58 2 mile. Yeah. Can you run a mile in under
8:58? That's like my, like, close to my mile. My mile's like,
I can probably bike a mile in that amount of time. I don't know. Well, shout out, shout out Mr. Albright. Happy birthday. And shout out Finn
happy
Shea.
Birthday.
Happy birthday. Have a great Friday.
Happy birthday, Zach Simakula.
Yes, happy birthday, Zach Simakula.
And happy birthday to Mr.
Ormore. Everyone gets a shout out. Have a great day, Flyers. Remember, the early bird gets the worm.